that the IB program is a program that is challenging, but also very accessible for any student who wishes to aspire to a project-based program that will challenge them on a college level to really prepare communication skills, research skills, writing skills. So I do believe that IB can be effective for any student who wishes to take it. The rigor of the program, however, might not be for everybody. So I feel like IB, and especially the DP program, is something that students who really feel that they want the challenge of that increased rigor and to have a lot of college level class experience before they go to college, that will maybe the path for them. But it certainly isn't for everybody. So for those students who choose not to go DP, at this school, they have wonderful opportunities because we offer honors courses and dual enrollment courses that will give them just as much preparation for college as what DP would. I guess the big difference, though, is looking at how the DP program is very whole student. So you're not just studying and reading and writing, but you are developing skills that prepare you for lots of things you may encounter in the world, such as research and public speaking and being able to plan out projects and meet goals and deadlines.
Okay, so the DP program for the IB, once you hit 11th and 12th grade, is a great program for anyone who's interested in really kind of going forward with their art, who can work independently and is willing to go beyond just like the basics that you have in a regular art class. Students have a lot more freedom in those classes, so they can kind of choose which mediums and what they like the best and the styles that they like to work with the most. And then they just kind of create their own style from that. And at the end of the program, they have three different culminating projects, basically, that they have to complete. There's a comparative study, which is a PowerPoint that kind of explains different styles of art and how they connect to them. Another is a process portfolio where they keep a video, well, not a video, but a documented a PowerPoint of all of their work, their portfolios, so it's a lot of photographs of what they've done and the different mediums that they've worked with throughout the 2 years. And then the final piece is an exhibition that they put on at the end of their 2-year program, and it's all about what they have accomplished over the 2 years
in
the DP program.
Sophomores at Signal Mountain Middle High School have two choices of academic paths that they can choose. One is the IB path, and it is more of a rigorous study culture that students need to buy into to really be successful in the program. The other option is the honors, just academic program, which is still very challenging at Signal Mountain compared to other schools in the county. So either way, you're going to be successful. One requires more of an academic buy-in into the whole program, DP, IB, and the other one is Tennessee standards, which are still rigorous and useful.
So the benefits of IB education is what I always call or think of as best practices. It's trying to learn and problem solve. I think it's very beneficial for the college environment because a lot of things you have to do are independent learning aspects where you're working in small groups, and that's what IB education, IB planning, and IB classes kind of promote.
All right, I think IB classes are great, but I took honors classes and I also think that those are just as good, and I got great experience out of my honors classes.
I took IB film because I enjoyed broadcast, and IB film is helpful because it helps for college and it prepares me.
I chose IB because I figured it would help with college.
I chose IB because I really wanted to take IB German because both my grandparents are German and I wanted to learn the language.
Has IB helped me prepare for college? Yes, it has helped me prepare for college because it's hard and we do a lot of work